Now, if you have watched X-Men Apocalypse, then you should clearly remember this scene from the movie. In the movie, Quicksilver moves so fast that he slows down the time enough to save everyone from the mansion. Now, this scene is kind of cool. So, after watching this scene, so many people do wonder, what if they possessed this power in real life? Wouldn't be that cool? Well, I am going to say that it wouldn't. Because if you try to use that power, you will surely die. Hello, cyber citizens, welcome to What the Science, the channel where we see everything in a scientist way. The question of this episode is whether we can travel at the speed of light. The clear answer is no, but let's consider that you can, and let's see what happens when you travel with the speed of light. For starters, let's not start with the speed of light, let's start with 10% of the speed of light and see what happens to you, because as far as I am concerned, I am not really inclined to traveling with the speed of light, and I am pretty much sure that when I am done with this episode, you won't either be. Let's start with less severe things. Traveling at the speed of light can make you blind. The reason is because there is a time lag between the things happening and we seeing them. For example, whenever we observe some object, the light gets reflected from that object and we receive it on our eyes, and from the eyes, the information is traveled back to our brain, where the brain creates an image of the object. So it takes some time for our brain to process the information that we are receiving. But when we are traveling at the speed of light or traveling very fast, we are collecting so much information such that the brain finds it too difficult to process all that information, and we get a blurry image instead of well-defined image that usually happens. So it's like we become partially blind. This problem is very much real for the insect called as tiger beetle. This insect is very fast. Due to this speed, the insect can't see its surroundings while traveling at such a speed. So in order to compensate that, the insect stops in between so that it can see its surroundings and make sure that it is not hitting anything on the way. Now let's increase the severity. Now the downside to traveling very fast is that you can't travel that fast anywhere. The reason is that if you try to travel with such speed on Earth, you will encounter air molecules traveling in the opposite direction, and these air molecules will create so much friction that you will instantaneously catch yourself on fire. And this will turn your body into a pile of ash, and you can't reach anywhere if you are traveling with that speed. And if somehow you saved yourself from burning out, then there comes another problem: insects. Traveling at very high speeds will make these harmless insects like bullets. Now, if you are traveling at near light speeds, then these insects will impact on your body with so much force at a very small area that will be enough to overcome the tensile strength of your skin and your muscles and everything like that. Then the insect will pierce through you like a bullet. And as you know that insects form the largest species on planet Earth, so even if the air molecules didn't get you, insects surely will. Now you might think to travel in some other place where there are no air molecules and insects to deal with, for example in space, thinking that you can survive here. But you are wrong. Even if the space is considered mostly empty, it has billions of atoms floating around. You will be encountering many atoms on your way, and when these atoms impact you, they will be releasing large amount of radiation, which itself is enough to kill you. So long story short, traveling with the speed of light looks cool in the movies, but in real life you can't reach the speed of light, and even if you do, traveling at that speed is enough to kill you. And to dodge a bullet, you just need to have quick reflexes, because traveling faster towards a bullet will help the bullet to kill you faster. Because whenever you are moving towards an object and the object is moving towards you, then the speed will get added up and the time gets reduced. So less time to react, so you die faster. That's it from this episode. Hope you liked it. If you liked it, please click the subscribe button and then to the bell icon to the side of it so that you get notified every time we post something new on this channel. And you can also hit the like button if you really like this, and you can click on the link above to find more playlists from the channel. And if you want to watch some other science related videos, you can click on the videos appearing on your screen. Thank you for watching.